Sister asked a question. He said that one Muslim became murtad. He poses a question again in the Quran, or she. And that person poses a question on Surah Baqarah, starting few verses. We say that Allah guides those who have taqwa. So the question is that what is the use of guiding those who have taqwa? It is that those who don't have taqwa should be guided. I'll give you an example, a simple example to answer this question. That in a class where a teacher teaches the student, she but naturally teaches all the students same. She's giving a lecture. But she says that those who follow my instructions will pass the examination. The teacher teaches the same to all the students. If the 100 students, she teaches the same thing. But those who follow the teacher, or those who have the yearning or the desire to obey the teacher, they obey the teacher's instruction and they study hard and they pass the examination. So the teacher says that those who have the desire to obey me will get guidance from my lecture and pass the examination. So you come and tell teacher, what's the use of those who have the desire to listen to you passing the examination? Those who don't have the desire should pass. So the teacher says, okay, fine, that those who don't have the desire to pass, I will pass them. So it is illogical. This is the examination. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Mulk, chapter number 16, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It is Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good in deeds. This life is the test for the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought us human beings in this world as a test for the hereafter. And we are undergoing a test. And Allah says in the Quran that if he wanted, he could have made each and every human being a Muslim. Very easy for him. If he wanted, he could have made each and every human being a Muslim and all would have gone to Jannah. But then where is the test? That category is already there, the angels. The angel is a category of creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who never disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah says, they obey. So what will be the difference between the angels and us? The difference between the human being and the angel is that the angels don't have a free will of their own. Whatever Allah says, they obey. The human being and the jinn, we have a free will. We can either obey Allah or we can disobey Allah. After a free will is given to us, if we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow his commandments, we become higher than the angels. But after the free will is given and if we don't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we become the partner of the Satan. So this life is a test for the hereafter. So Allah says that all those who have taqwa, Allah will guide them. Allah says in several verses, including Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 69, that all those who strive in my way, I will open up their pathways. So if someone objects that Allah has opened up the pathways for those who strive in his way, it is illogical. He should open up the pathways for those who don't strive. So for example, if I'm giving a medical examination and if I'm teaching the medical students, those who don't follow the textbook, they will pass. So these doctors, when they come out, they will not treat the patient, they will kill the patients. And Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 160, that if Allah helps you, none can overcome you. If Allah forsakes you, who is there then who can help you? So let the believers put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What the Quran says, that if you have faith in Allah, Allah is bound to help you and you are bound to be successful. If you are not successful, it is not Allah who is to be blamed. It is you who is to be blamed. Allah promises that if you strive in his way, he'll open up your pathway. If your pathways have not been opened, don't blame Allah, you have to blame yourself. Allah never tells a lie. Allah is just. So if we analyze, read the Quran, Allah is giving us guidance. He forgives the mistakes. Many mistakes human beings make, he forgives us. But at the same time he says that all those who strive in his way, all those who have taqwa, all those who have the yearning to sacrifice, Allah will surely help you and guide you. Those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So only thing we should have is taqwa, is the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Should strive in his way and inshallah we'll be successful in this world and the akhirah. Hope that answers the question, sister. Wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.